Corticon makes it easy to create and update complex business rules that can be deployed as .NET web services. This video demonstrates how to set up and configure Internet Information Services, or IIS, 8.5 on Windows Server 2012, R2. This demonstration uses a virtual machine with Corticon .NET Server installed. Having looked at the Microsoft setup instructions for IIS, they are too general to ensure that we get the right mix of options and dependencies for our use case. Corticon requires .NET Framework 4.5 or higher. First, we'll verify that it is installed. While you could assume that it is always installed with the OS, verifying it is a good practice. The install folder for 4.5 is within the 4.0 folder location, so let's dig deeper. As Microsoft describes it in their MSDN topic, you can dig into the registry to see the 4.0 version details. This machine uses a supported version, 4.5.2. Now, we'll set up IIS. Windows Server 2012 R2 includes the IIS 8.5 files, but the feature is not enabled by default. We launch the Server Manager, and then choose Add Roles and Features. Click Next. Choose role-based or feature-based installation, and then click Next. For server selection, the current installation should be pre-selected, so click Next. On the Server Roles panel, scroll down to choose Web Server, IIS. The Server Manager alerts us that this will require the IIS Management Console, which we accept by clicking Add Features. Then click Next. On the Features panel, expand groups to choose Specific, .NET Framework 3.5 and 4.5 features, as well as the supporting WCF service features, so we can expand these groups. First, choose .NET Framework 3.5, which opens a dialog to add required features. Click Add Features. This will move the 3.5 .NET framework into the file system and the registry. Choose the HTTP activation feature in 3.5. And now, do the same for 4.5. That opens a dialog to add required features. Click Add Features. Select TCP activation. Click Next. Skip this panel by clicking Next. On the Role Services panel, select HTTP redirection and WebDAV publishing. Scroll down to the Application Development section and expand it. Some of these features were added by our previous selections. Choose ASP, ASP.NET 3.5, and CGI, then click Next. The pre-selected options might not include all the features required for Corticon.NET Server, so it's good to verify that the required features are selected. On the confirmation panel, review that the selections are complete and correct. That is always a good idea. We can also export the selections as a template, like this. All set. Click Install. It will take a few minutes. Click Close. Now let's confirm that both of the .NET Framework versions are now installed. We open a new File Explorer window to get a fresh look. There they are, all set. Now we need to install our Corticon.NET Server folder and resources into the IIS location. We launch the script install.bat located in Corticon Server.NET's IIS folder. We accept the default IIS location, so we just press Enter. In just a few seconds, that's done. There's just a few steps left. The Corticon.NET Server that we set up for IIS Web Services needs to be handled as an application. To do that, launch the IIS Manager, expand this machine, expand Sites, and then click Default Website. Right-click and select Refresh. Expand the tree to navigate to the Access Directory. That's the directory where the install script put all the Corticon.NET resources. Right-click on the Access folder, and then choose Convert to Application. The Add Application dialog opens. Click Select. The Select Application Pool dialog opens. On the Application Pool pull-down, choose .NET v4.5 Classic. Click OK on both dialog boxes. You might need to set access permissions for access directories so that users can write to various subdirectories in the access installation. We'll check to see whether the v4.5 Classic application pool that runs under the build in user account application pool identity has write permissions for the access folders. We need to set these. Right-click on the Access application and choose Edit Permissions. Choose the Security tab and then click Edit. In the Permissions for Access dialog, we select the group IIS_IUSRS. On Write Permission, choose Allow. Click Apply and then click OK. Click OK. The setup is now complete. It is a good idea to restart IIS now. In the IIS Manager, right-click on the root to choose Stop, and then after a few seconds, click Start. The IIS Windows 2012 R2 with Internet Information Services 8.5 is now running the Access Web Service and Corticon 5.x as ASP.NET 4.5 web services. We'll do a quick test of the web service in a browser to confirm that the server is running and listening on default port 80. Great. Now let's send a request. In the Corticon bin, we choose Corticon_API_remote_test. Command 120 shows the decision services running on our .NET server. Let's pass the process order sample request to its decision service on the ISS server. It ran. Let's look at the response. Everything is working as intended. Once you have a production license jar, you need to overwrite the evaluation license. I have one here in the Documents folder. I'll copy it. Navigate to the IIS location and then paste it to overwrite the evaluation license. That completes our demonstration of setting up Microsoft Internet Information Services 8.5 on a Windows Server 2012 R2 system to support Corticon .NET Server. Thank you.